Hello Galactic Family. Welcome aboard. Gaia Planetary Station is happy that you like the messages and information we communicate. Help the channel to grow by subscribing, commenting on the video, sharing, becoming a member and donating to the channel. We always appreciate good energies and vibrations. We are together in this new era ground crew, stay strong. Victory of Light. A new era is approaching for humanity. Many have speculated about it, and it is known that it will come after a major cleaning/change that is already taking place will be on the planet. It will come with the tribulations of the geological, climatic changes, just to change the paradigms for the new human race is being born, more aware, in an era of peace, where brotherhood reigns, where man will live for his fellow man. There will be a great revival spirit worldwide. The evolution of the human race. Evolution and karma. The age of Aquarius will bring profound changes to the planet Earth and its inhabitants. The entire planet will be renewed physically and energetically, then providing pleasant and mild climates without the raging storms and floods we know today. A world free of disease, wickedness where everyone is aware of respect for nature and love of neighbor. Life will no longer be a burden. To live in the physical planes will no longer be as difficult and painful as it is currently. Nowadays many people are trapped in reincarnation cycles, as in many experiences accumulated negative experiences in their source and the universe. But with the end of the current cycle humanity will be ending so the karmic cycles, for the third millennium only remain on Earth those whose karma have been completely exhausted. This is the basic condition for the beings currently living in the physical planes can ascend to the fourth/fifth dimension. The earthly karma exhaustion process is already happening, and the results of this are clearly visible. The increasing number of suicides, murders, thefts, in short all the evils of mankind are currently surfacing because karma in many past lives is active in this current incarnation of the people. That is, they must eliminate karma acquired so far in this present existence, in addition to previous karma. For this reason, we must have the force inside, and a real desire to evolve spiritually. The spiritual requirement is relative, because in fact the nature imposes us anything. A person can decide if she wants, for example, continue living in their illusions and thus not ascend to the fourth dimension. The choice is a right of all beings. Is the free will granted by Source will all creatures of the universe. But if a person really wants to evolve, it will resort to all the illusions you live in, and start an unconditional quest for true evolution. She will not care about the degree of requirements internal, for his desire to evolve is unconditional, so she will do anything to evolve, and will spare no efforts to adapt to the new vibrations of the fourth dimension. So who actually intend to follow this evolution of the planet? Should start internally this great search. After the great changes in all working systems, as soon as the thorough cleaning of the Earth is made, people will build a wonderful new civilization. This reconstruction will also have the help of aliens, who will provide the equipment and technical assistance. It will start then, a new era of light on Earth. Glorious times will come, and malice, hatred, revenge, selfishness disappear forever. Will be a new era in which there will be no fighting for survival as we know it today. With the dimensional transition the laws of nature will change positively, and thus recognize the new laws of nature, which in the third dimension in were unknown because we lived in a dense dimension. Thus, to obtain food and other survival resources exist other ways easier. In the fourth and fifth dimension you can materialize objects with thought, making a number of things. With the field of clairvoyance, telepathy and clairvoyance, it is not always necessary to do what we call in this world trip. Finally, we will live a new and glorious era, and from this moment on the man reach faster their spiritual fullness, the man then will the universe to its reach. In time the earth will experience other rises, then ascending to the fifth dimension, Friday, and so on. A wonderful future awaits us, but only come to him when we can feel and radiate in the most intense, the most noble of sentiments, the greatest feeling this universe and all creation, unconditional love. Who are we? As we go forward in the way of living from our hearts, the true nature of who we are will become clearer to us. There are many things that were retained and omitted in that we forget about the truth of who we are. We are all spiritual beings having a human experience. In the heart of this statement is the beautiful truth of who really us. We know that when we find a quiet space for contemplation and meditation, we can feel the truth of this statement. From the perspective of the fifth dimension, we are merely another aspect of one. This is an ideal way to think about us and that many strive to relate to each other in this way, but there is still too much importance placed on our physical representations, the matter around us, which clouds our vision and prevents us from seeing this perspective, our earthly experience, the race to which we belong, the characteristics that define us, gender and sexuality, the superficial details that decide in which society layer we live, and the perception of power or influence that is available because of these characteristics are considered very important. Some cases, they even mean the difference between life and death. But as we continue to discover our true nature, we begin to see the irrelevance of these details and see that they truly have as few importance and influence on us because we realize they have the purpose of these perceived differences as few as it is important to be there to teach maximum lesson that any being can learn. All are connected, all truly are one, and the only inequalities that exist are those that are kept alive through the adherence to the perception of these disequality. In our very near future, the time is coming when we will begin to see we all truly are a family living on a planet in one of many universes and a reality that is as few as one of many realities. This coming time we'll be able to clearly see and begin to understand that our perceived physical differences are used against us to maintain the illusion of separation ahead of our perception is something very powerful to believe that because a person has skin color or gender or religious affiliation diverse and therefore is different from the other, means that it is somehow more or less power. We know that much history was written based on these perceived differences, but we must have the courage to begin to feel that our true path is beyond these differences. If we could see us from our perspective, we would see that the most important things are our individual vibrations of love and light are those that contribute the largest collective vibrations of love and light. Those truly are only things important. Why in the end, the only differences are those that we insist on perpetuating the repetition of our history. We know we are not alone in this crucial moment of transformation and evolution of the race and the planet and that there are certain groups who rely on us. The higher hierarchies of light with us, help us and monitor us lovingly, stimulating our awakening. However, respecting our free will, we continue making our choices, no matter what happened, a decision to move forward, evolving, ascending is always ours. But if we keep repeating, reviving and reliving these events as we continue to focus on the differences we perceive and fall into the fallacy that our mere physical appearances, which have materially or power control we exert over others, mean something in the grand scheme of things, just keep the barriers these illusions working. We should not judge us for it. It is understandable that when the vibrational frequency of these events is kept alive by many people and they continue to focus on them, it is very easy to make the choice to continue to access our many who say yearn for the day when all people on the planet are equal, and then at the same time, keep repeating the story that has maintained the illusion of separation. There are many who yearn love and unity, but continue to focus on the vibrations of violence and oppression. Independently when these events occurred in our timeline of history, when we focus on them in our physical now, we bring the same vibration, separation and injustice to our present time, but we must not minimize the events that seem so horrible and unjust on our planet. But we must remember that all come from the source and all are truly connected. Know in no other source of life than Font. All we choose to represent the roles that we are representing so we could learn the lessons we needed/wanted learn. We chose to incarnate in physical reality we now inhabit, it is a fact. All souls, with great excitement and love, chose dive into the physical body that now inhabit because we knew that this was the most loving and effective way to learn the lesson that needed to be learned. Until those we perceive as oppressors who have chosen to play the role of oppressor. Look absurd, but that's how free will works. If the Earth 3D reality game there was nothing to overcome, then there would be no reason to triumph or victory when we begin to see that each action and life began with an individual choice, We can begin to see that each action and life are as few otherwise for all souls reach the top of the mountain. Using a metaphor, a choral is just made up of a group of individuals who have decided to come together and sing together as a movement, or a revolution consists of a group of individuals who decided they wanted to try something new, something born of love and equality. Those visions of a world coexisting peacefully well from a love and compassion space are not as difficult to achieve as we were led to believe. So it takes a step to begin a journey and a note to get a song. So it takes a seed to start a garden and a tree to start a forest. There are some who have chosen to incarnate again as those who try to keep separate and scared people, but their power is as few as large as those they overwhelm allow to be. So we can start to change when a person at a time decide to create something new. After all, we cannot start a journey in a new direction while continuing to look back and talking about past. Those new journey of evolution on the planet can only get through the focused intent of heart that want to experience freedom and joy dwarf only for themselves but for all. We cannot keep us trapped in fear and oppression and hope to provide something different that for those we want to help. We were taught to think that in the end justice will be done with those who deny. But do not understand that if a soul chose to play the role of one who denies justice, which generally cannot be in your character, do the opposite. Justice begins when we realize that it is our right to have it. Freedom begins before the acceptance of who we are. Joy and love will come when we realize that they are our natural state and that they have always existed somewhere within us. A new way to feel, think and act. For many of us these words do not ring true, because we think we are committed to fight for those oppressed are held accountable for their power. We may ask, since everything truly originates from an individual choice, how can there be anything else than what we choose? When we decided to find others who have chosen to love, others who have chosen freedom, others who have chosen self-waiting, joy and abundance, then we begin to see the power of our vibration as individuals and as a collective. Coming back to the metaphor of choral. A choral, 1 million singing the same song, those who sing a single disharmonious note at the end will be muffled and choose. Or exit the choral or change the tone and sing along us. The only thing we have to do is continue to focus on the glory of the music that brings joy to our hearts and reshape the universe to take us to others who sing the same song. When we let the perceptions of our physical bodies and our place in the illusion of a social hierarchy define who we are, we make a disservice by not arise allow the totality of who are forgot us of what we see and begin to focus on we fell. First take care of us and then do what we can to take care of others. No focus on the tactics of those who would keep us in bondage to fear and anxiety but focalize us to raise our vibrations of love and light. If you do that let us feel small and afraid, so it's not good for our soul, if we need to justify or explain why they have made a choice, they seem right and true in our hearts, then it is right and true for us because we choose. As we all chose to live this life so we can learn what we most wanted learn is only when we refuse to learn the lesson that things become tangled and confused. Fear and freedom are contradictory to each other, and those which are intended to keep us trapped in fear, really they are not interested in seeing us free. When are free, there is nothing to fear and when we are afraid, we can never be free. Life then, from our hearts. We forgive the past illusions and begin to live now as we wish to see others living. 12. The DNA of Phyla, Our Spiritual Heritage. By Kate A. Sprickley. For years science has recognized that we have two physical asset strands of DNA. In addition to these, we have 10 energy strands which have been dormant in the human being for centuries. These dormant strands of DNA were discovered by scientists, not knowing what would be their function. Identified them as junk DNA. The deoxyribonucleic acid DNA is a nucleic acid that contains all the genetic instructions used in the development and operation of all living things. The main function of the DNA is the long-term information storage. DNA is often compared to a set of projects, since it contains the instructions needed to construct other components of cells. The DNA segments that carry genetic information are called genes, but other DNA sequences have structural purposes or are involved in regulating the use of genetic. So information, our DNA is our personal project and as such contains all the information our mental, physical, emotional and spiritual. The original human being had 12 strands of DNA actively working and maintaining the full function of the human as a spiritual being. With our concern for excessive thinking through the left side of the brain, and the closing of our heart centers, these extra DNA strands were lost. As a result of this loss, we went to live in a spiritually deficient society and our intuitive and healing abilities have been reduced drastically. Another result of this loss is that we access and use only a small part of our brain. Human body is the most valuable thing that ever possess. It stores and maintains a wealth of information, wisdom and knowledge on every aspect of ourselves, our world and all life. Combinations of intelligence are stored within the human being, and a large amount of data is stored within the body. Within our bodies are the formulas needed to play other forms of intelligence throughout the universe. On moment of conception, we receive of our two different bloodlines our parents certain combinations and pairs of recessive genes. These genes contain the light codes that give us the greatest opportunity to access and develop our capabilities in spiritual healing the damaged and wounded aspects of our soul. At the same time, these genes contain memories that have created roadblocks in our path to oneness and initiated our deep-seated feelings of separation, separation from our true essence and our Creator. These separation memories forced us to create experiences and situations in which we are given opportunities to heal ourselves, our world and our divisions. As souls, carefully choose our parents and their bloodlines in order to facilitate experiences and situations they allow us to heal ourselves. Therefore, we handpicked our own DNA structures and the possible opportunities to activate and awaken other DNA strands. The energy of our Earth is going through major vibrational shifts and moving to higher levels of consciousness. As the Earth raises its vibration, we as human beings, we are getting many opportunities to raise our vibration. This change is being called the Ascension and there are many people around the world who are experiencing confusion and chaos in their worlds. However, this apparent chaos and confusion find great opportunities for growth, expansion and evolution. One of the most exciting aspects of our evolutionary process is the reorganization of our DNA. Cosmic rays-coded light of our Creator have come to our Earth stimulating change and reordering our human bodies. As the encoded light filaments are absorbed in our body dispersed, our DNA is being reactivated and remodeled into new DNA strands or helices and being reordered into bundles. As this rebundling and this reordering progress, we create a more evolved nervous system that facilitates new information and data coming into our consciousness. Many of sleeper cells of our brain are being awakened and we are being able to access the full potential of our body. As our bodies fill with more light, our memories are opened, and as our DNA evolves, we evolve into beings multidimensional conscient. Our 12 strands of DNA activate and connect to our 12 chakra, energy portals through which we access our spiritual heritage. The 12 strands of DNA serve as a link, through our 12 chakras with the external power network to our bodies. The 12 chakras act as energetic doorways into our body connecting us to the vital forces of existence. It is through opening and activating these portals of energy that we can begin to really know ourselves. As now all 12 DNA strands are forming, a matter which has not been elaborated and clarified peacefully in our personal history, will create chaos. Feelings and memories are surfacing, offering us an opportunity to experience the fabric of our being and revealing who we are through the events and beliefs that are intricately woven into us. Our task is to awaken, activate and unite all 12. Creating a rotation of 12. This rotation of the 12 strands of DNA and 12 chakra will attract to us energies that will intermix and move through our beings, activating and awakening the many different aspects of ourselves. This will trigger new versions, understandings and meanings to all the events in our lives and in our world. 12 chakras are energy sets which may arise events. They hold memory and the identity and each corresponds to one strand of DNA. These 12 energy centers must be accessed from within, where we can feel the corresponding data and translating our experiences within the context of our mind. When open our hearts and minds, all the answers to the great mysteries will be found within us. It takes us to remove us from our current belief systems and to create new belief systems, for the mind is structured to evolve and form our experiences based on what we ordered. Our mind is not our master. We are the masters of our own minds. The mind is only a tool to be used to create reality, and nothing else. Consciously working with the waves of energy and light that enter our land, we are able to realize and understand that the transformation of this planet is based on the healing and power of our mind. An activation of the full 12 DNA strands will create a connection between our human genetic coding and give us access to all knowledge and wisdom. This is the awareness and understanding of who we really are. So we activate all 12 strands of DNA, we create an alignment within ourselves, allowing us to gently shift vibration levels and frequencies of light much higher, helping our ascension process to the awaken our human consciousness. Source: www.spiritpathways.co.za. Kate Sprickly. Copyright 2008. Related posts: Thoughts and DNA. DNA accelerated by merger of galaxies. Activation of exponential DNA. Frequency of DNA in the human body. Part DNA 1-2-3. Biology belief. Dr. Bruce Lipton, PhD. Dr. Deepak Chopra. East: The quantum key cure for self-healing and emotional balance. A deliberate how raise your creation vibration energy. Global rise in mass wave X. Going bathing the earth. September wave X. Disperter of the SCP wave X 2015. Dr. Forecasts of Atkins. Human spiritual 1. You do not need to seek a connection with the spirit. He is fully aware of what is spirit, and all the experiences of life, individual and collective, are spiritual expressions. Does not feel separate from any part of creation, feeling intimately connected with the whole. 2. Not afraid of change, individual or collective. You know that every experience is a growth experience and a chance to recreate his own divine presence in human form. He knows the nature of illusion in which he lives and uses it to enhance personal experience and serve humanity. 3. It has no feelings of low esteem. You know that no fragment of all that is has less value and worth than any other. Does not compare with other anyway, privately or publicly, and feels self-conscious of itself, no more than others. Not envy or pity from anyone else. 4. Honor all needs and desires above all others. You know that one can truly serve others will from a codependency or victim, and cannot love anyone without first love. 5. Know fully that truth is not maintained by someone or something outside themselves, and that the only truth is found within. No need to know, because it has access to everything you ever needed through the higher intuition. 6. You cannot be unfaithful to himself. Does not commit to their own reality and viewpoints in favor of others. Lives embodied life on the basis of I choose and not the I'm afraid. Actions are consistent with words. It does not say one thing and does another. You have no feelings of humiliation. 7. There can be faults with others. He has no desire to misrepresent, to manipulate or control people or events, to be reserved, to be greedy or dishonest even in small details. Lives in the highest integrity at all times. You have the wisdom to know when to speak and when silence, when to act and when not to, but will not change the expression of inner truth in the interest of others. You know that what benefits one must benefit the all in order that the divine order to be maintained. It gives and receives in a balanced flow. 8. Be confident in yourself and consequently trusts others. You know that there are no errors or failures, only choices. It is in tune with the higher consciousness which is orchestrating the divine flow of our human experience and evolution. You have no feelings of guilt, shame, or indecision. It is unaffected by the criticism of others. 9. Has desire to prove right and wrong. You know that all points of view are equally valid and an inherent right of free will. Determines and enforces personal boundaries based on choice rather than fear. He does not argue, nor is dedicated to power struggles. 10. Non-critical and not judge others directly or indirectly. I do not mind listening to criticize and chatter. Do not whine. It does not try to stir up drama and conflict amongst others. Fully knows that the need to criticize and discuss comes from fear. Grants all others the right to be as they are. Do not confuse the actions of the other with being the other. You know that all beings are divine and equal. 11. Opera in the time now. The embodied consciousness is not far in the past or in the future, but only in the now moment and the chosen experience of this moment. Do not worry or have regrets. 12. Is fully able to experience the full extent of human emotion, in addition to being able to choose which emotions or feeling any human experience. No experience uncontrolled and impetuous emotional response of most humans. 13 makes the choices and decisions of life on higher intuition, rather than the linear and logical thinking, or the survival instincts based on fear of the emotional body. You know that the higher intuition operates in divine flow and is not subject to the inconsistencies of the emotional or mental body. You do not need reasons other than I choose. 14 Do you know the true meaning of love and is incapable of loving any part of creation more or less than any other party? You do not need any particular kind of relationship with other humans, animals, etc. Chooses to intensify relationships with other life experience and releases those who do not do so. You know that you cannot hurt the other, unless the other at some level, has chosen this experience. You know that you cannot be hurt unless you have also chosen this experience. 15 Do not fear any part of creation. Does not experience concern and apprehension. Does not feel threatened by the thoughts, words and actions of any other body, individual or collective, but is alert and aware of the immediate environment and the potential choices presented by it. 16 Do not get attached to people or other forms of life, places or things. Does not suffer from separation or death, because he knows that we are all eternally connected in the One and that the separation that seems to exist on the earth plane is an illusion. 17 Does not experience the normal variations of human life, because it is free of karma and operates at a frequency level above duality. Rarely experiences the illness or injury, because the body is free from the influence of lower emotional thoughts. You can transmute lower energies of others without being affected by them. 18 Do not judge or condemn the events of the world. Know they are a manifestation of the collective consciousness and the most powerful tool to change the world is the very transformation. You can choose to work actively for change in the world if so guided by the higher intuition. 19 is able to act with genuine compassion at all times, serving humanity and providing the aid that is needed in a higher place and no judgment. Has no personal agenda or motivations for assisting others. Choose to do this or not, based on the higher intuition. 20 It has no interest in putting yourself above others, controlling the beliefs or actions of others, taking the personal power of others. It has nothing to prove to others. 21 Honor the limitations imposed by others, individual and collective. Respects the free will and personal space of others at all times and the laws of the land in which he lives. Occasionally chooses exceeds a limit, but does this taking full responsibility for possible consequences. 22 Ups every day with a sense of joy and excitement about what may prove. You have no expectations about what can be experienced, but takes full responsibility as a co-creator. You want to fully experience all that co-created. 23 is an extremely powerful catalyst for change transmutational on Earth. Radiates the higher frequencies of love, light and joy continuously in the planetary consciousness. Cure and transmute the energies of fear for the Earth and its life forms, simply by being in human form, a new era is approaching for humanity. Many have speculated about it, and it is known that it will come after a major cleaning/change that is already taking place will be on the planet. It will come with the tribulations of the geological, climatic changes, just to change the paradigms for the new human race is being born, more aware, in an era of peace, where brotherhood reigns, where man will live for his fellow man. There will be a great revival spirit worldwide. The evolution of the human race. Evolution and karma. The age of Aquarius will bring profound changes to the planet Earth and its inhabitants. The entire planet will be renewed physically and energetically, then providing pleasant and mild climates without the raging storms and floods we know today. A world free of disease, wickedness where everyone is aware of respect for nature and love of neighbor. Life will no longer be a burden, to live in the physical planes will no longer be as difficult and painful as it is currently. Nowadays many people are trapped in reincarnation cycles, as in many experiences accumulated negative experiences in their source and the universe. But with the end of the current cycle humanity will be ending so the karmic cycles, for the third millennium only remain on Earth those whose karma have been completely exhausted. This is the basic condition for the beings currently living in the physical planes can ascend to the fourth/fifth dimension. The earthly karma exhaustion process is already happening, and the results of this are clearly visible. The increasing number of suicides, murders, thefts, in short all the evils of mankind are currently surfacing because karma in many past lives is active in this current incarnation of the people. That is, they must eliminate karma acquired so far in this present existence, in addition to previous karma. For this reason, we must have the force inside, and a real desire to evolve spiritually. The spiritual requirement is relative, because in fact the nature imposes us anything. A person can decide if she wants, for example, continue living in their illusions and thus not ascend to the fourth dimension. The choice is a right of all beings, is the free will granted by Source will all creatures of the universe. But if a person really wants to evolve, it will resort to all the illusions you live in, and start an unconditional quest for true evolution. She will not care about the degree of requirements internal, for his desire to evolve is unconditional, so she will do anything to evolve, and will spare no efforts to adapt to the new vibrations of the fourth dimension. So who actually intend to follow this evolution of the planet, should start internally this great search. After the great changes in all working systems, as soon as the thorough cleaning of the earth is made, people will build a wonderful new civilization. This reconstruction will also have the help of aliens, who will provide the equipment and technical assistance. It will start then, a new era of light on earth. Glorious times will come, and malice, hatred, revenge, selfishness disappear forever. Will be a new era in which there will be no fighting for survival as we know it today. With the dimensional transition, the laws of nature will change positively, and thus recognize the new laws of nature, which in the third dimension in were unknown because we lived in a dense dimension. Thus, to obtain food and other survival resources exist other ways easier. In the fourth and fifth dimension you can materialize objects with thought, making a number of things. With the field of clairvoyance, telepathy and clairvoyance, it is not always necessary to do what we call in this world trip. Finally, we will live a new and glorious era, and from this moment on the man reach faster their spiritual fullness, the man then will the universe to its reach. In time the earth will experience other rises, then ascending to the fifth dimension, Friday, and so on. A wonderful future awaits us, but only come to him when we can feel and radiate in the most intense, the most noble of sentiments, the greatest feeling this universe and all creation, unconditional love. Who are we? As we go forward in the way of living from our hearts, the true nature of who we are will become clearer to us. There are many things that were retained and omitted in that we forget about the truth of who we are. We are all spiritual beings having a human experience. In the heart of this statement is the beautiful truth of who really us. We know that when we find a quiet space for contemplation and meditation, we can feel the truth of this statement. From the perspective of the fifth dimension, we are merely another aspect of one. This is an ideal way to think about us and that many strive to relate to each other in this way, but there is still too much importance placed on our physical representations, the matter around us, which clouds our vision and prevents us from seeing this perspective, our earthly experience, the race to which we belong, the characteristics that define us, gender and sexuality, the superficial details that decide in which society layer we live and the perception of power or influence that is available because of these characteristics are considered very important. Some cases, they even mean the difference between life and death. But as we continue to discover our true nature, we begin to see the irrelevance of these details and see that they truly have as few importance and influence on us because we realize they have the purpose of these perceived differences as few as it is important to be there to teach maximum lesson that any being can learn. All are connected, all truly are one, and the only inequalities that exist are those that are kept alive through the adherence to the perception of these disequality. In our very near future, the time is coming when we will begin to see we all truly are a family living on a planet in one of many universes and a reality that is as few as one of many realities. This coming time we'll be able to clearly see and begin to understand that our perceived physical differences are used against us to maintain the illusion of separation ahead of our perception is something very powerful to believe that because a person has skin color or gender or religious affiliation diverse and therefore is different from the other, means that it is somehow more or less power. We know that much history was written based on these perceived differences, but we must have the courage to begin to feel that our true path is beyond these differences. If we could see us from our perspective, we would see that the most important things are our individual vibrations of love and light are those that contribute the largest collective vibrations of love and light. Those truly are only things important, why in the end, the only differences are those that we insist on perpetuating the repetition of our history. We know we are not alone in this crucial moment of transformation and evolution of the race and the planet and that there are certain groups who rely on us. The higher hierarchies of light with us, help us and monitor us lovingly, stimulating our awakening. However, respecting our free will, we continue making our choices, no matter what happened, a decision to move forward, evolving, ascending is always ours. But if we keep repeating, reviving and reliving these events as we continue to focus on the differences we perceive and fall into the fallacy that our mere physical appearances, which have materially or power control we exert over others, mean something in the grand scheme of things, just keep the barriers these illusions working. We should not judge us for it. It is understandable that when the vibrational frequency of these events is kept alive by many people and they continue to focus on them, it is very easy to make the choice to continue to access our many who say yearn for the day when all people on the planet are equal, and then at the same time, keep repeating the story that has maintained the illusion of separation. There are many who yearn love and unity, but continue to focus on the vibrations of violence and oppression. Independently when these events occurred in our timeline of history, when we focus on them in our physical now, we bring the same vibration separation and injustice to our present time, but we must not minimize the events that seem so horrible and unjust on our planet. But we must remember that all come from the source and all are truly connected. Know in no other source of life than Font. All we choose to represent the roles that we are representing so we could learn the lessons we needed / wanted learn. We chose to incarnate in physical reality we now inhabit, it is a fact. All souls, with great excitement and love, chose dive into the physical body that now inhabit because we knew that this was the most loving and effective way to learn the lesson that needed to be learned. Until those we perceive as oppressors who have chosen to play the role of oppressor. Look absurd, but that's how free will works. If the Earth 3D reality game there was nothing to overcome, then there would be no reason to triumph or victory. When we begin to see that each action and life begin with an individual choice, we can begin to see that each action and life are as few otherwise, for all souls reach the top of the mountain. Using a metaphor, a choral is just made up of a group of individuals who have decided to come together and sing together as a movement, or a revolution consists of a group of individuals who decided they wanted to try something new, something born of love and equality. Those visions of a world coexisting peacefully well from a love and compassion space are not as difficult to achieve as we were led to believe. So it takes a step to begin a journey and a note to get a song. So it takes a seed to start a garden and a tree to start a forest. There are some who have chosen to incarnate again as those who try to keep separate and scared people, but their power is as few as large as those they overwhelm allow to be. So we can start to change when a person at a time decide to create something new. After all, we cannot start a journey in a new direction while continuing to look back and talking about past. Those new journey of evolution on the planet can only get through the focused intent of heart that want to experience freedom and joy dwarf only for themselves but for all. We cannot keep us trapped in fear and oppression and hope to provide something different that for those we want to help. We were taught to think that in the end justice will be done with those who deny. But do not understand that if a soul chose to play the role of one who denies justice, which generally cannot be in your character, do the opposite. Justice begins when we realize that it is our right to have it. Freedom begins before the acceptance of who we are. Joy and love will come when we realize that they are our natural state and that they have always existed somewhere within us. A new way to feel, think and act. For many of us these words do not ring true, because we think we are committed to fight for those oppressed are held accountable for their power. We may ask, since everything truly originates from an individual choice, how can there be anything else than what we choose? When we decided to find others who have chosen to love, others who have chosen freedom, others who have chosen self-waiting, joy and abundance, Then we begin to see the power of our vibration as individuals and as a collective. Coming back to the metaphor of choral. A choral 1 million singing the same song, those who sing a single disharmonious note at the end will be muffled and choose. Or exit the choral or change the tone and sing along us. The only thing we have to do is continue to focus on the glory of the music that brings joy to our hearts and reshape the universe to take us to others who sing the same song. When we let the perceptions of our physical bodies and our place in the illusion of a social hierarchy define who we are, we make a disservice by not arise allow the totality of who are forgot us of what we see and begin to focus on we fell. First take care of us and then do what we can to take care of others. No focus on the tactics of those who would keep us in bondage to fear and anxiety but focalize us to raise our vibrations of love and light. If you do that let us feel small and afraid, so it's not good for our soul, if we need to justify or explain why they have made a choice, they seem right and true in our hearts, then it is right and true for us because we choose, as we all chose to live this life so we can learn what we most wanted learn is only when we refuse to learn the lesson that things become tangled and confused. Fear and freedom are contradictory to each other, and those which are intended to keep us trapped in fear, really they are not interested in seeing us free. When are free, there is nothing to fear and when we are afraid, we can never be free. Life then, from our hearts. We forgive the past illusions and begin to live now as we wish to see others living. 12. The DNA of Phyla, Our Spiritual Heritage. By Kate A. Sprickley. For years science has recognized that we have two physical asset strands of DNA. In addition to these, we have 10 energy strands which have been dormant in the human being for centuries. These dormant strands of DNA were discovered by scientists, not knowing what would be their function, identified them as junk DNA. The deoxyribonucleic acid DNA is a nucleic acid that contains all the genetic instructions used in the development and operation of all living things. The main function of the DNA is the long-term information storage. DNA is often compared to a set of projects, since it contains the instructions needed to construct other components of cells. The DNA segments that carry genetic information are called genes, but other DNA sequences have structural purposes or are involved in regulating the use of genetic. So information, our DNA is our personal project and as such contains all the information our mental, physical, emotional and spiritual. The original human being had 12 strands of DNA actively working and maintaining the full function of the human as a spiritual being. With our concern for excessive thinking through the left side of the brain, and the closing of our heart centers, these extra DNA strands were lost. As a result of this loss, we went to live in a spiritually deficient society and our intuitive and healing abilities have been reduced drastically. Another result of this loss is that we access and use only a small part of our brain. Human body is the most valuable thing that ever possess. It stores and maintains a wealth of information, wisdom and knowledge on every aspect of ourselves, our world and all life. Combinations of intelligence are stored within the human being, and a large amount of data is stored within the body. Within our bodies are the formulas needed to play other forms of intelligence throughout the universe. On moment of conception, we receive of our two different bloodlines our parents certain combinations and pairs of recessive genes. These genes contain the light codes that give us the greatest opportunity to access and develop our capabilities in spiritual healing the damaged and wounded aspects of our soul. At the same time, these genes contain memories that have created roadblocks in our path to oneness and initiated our deep-seated feelings of separation, separation from our true essence and our Creator. These separation memories forced us to create experiences and situations in which we are given opportunities to heal ourselves, our world and our divisions. As souls, carefully choose our parents and their bloodlines in order to facilitate experiences and situations they allow us to heal ourselves. Therefore we handpicked our own DNA structures and the possible opportunities to activate and awaken other DNA strands. The energy of our Earth is going through major vibrational shifts and moving to higher levels of consciousness. As the Earth raises its vibration, we as human beings, we are getting many opportunities to raise our vibration. This change is being called the ascension and there are many people around the world who are experiencing confusion and chaos in their worlds. However, this apparent chaos and confusion find great opportunities for growth, expansion and evolution. One of the most exciting aspects of our evolutionary process is the reorganization of our DNA. Cosmic rays coded light of our Creator have come to our Earth, stimulating change and reordering our human bodies. As the encoded light filaments are absorbed and are dispersed, our DNA is being reactivated and remodeled into new DNA strands or helices and being reordered into bundles. As this rebundling and this reordering progress, we create a more evolved nervous system that facilitates new information and data coming into our consciousness. Many of sleeper cells of our brain are being awakened and we are being able to access the full potential of our body. As our bodies fill with more light, our memories are opened, and as our DNA evolves, we evolve into beings multidimensional conscient. Our 12 strands of DNA activate and connect to our 12 chakra energy portals through which we access our spiritual heritage. The 12 strands of DNA serve as a link through our 12 chakras with the external power network to our bodies. The 12 chakras act as energetic doorways into our body, connecting us to the vital forces of existence. It is through opening and activating these portals of energy that we can begin to really know ourselves. As now all 12 DNA strands are forming, a matter which has not been elaborated and clarified peacefully in our personal history, will create chaos. Feelings and memories are surfacing, offering us an opportunity to experience the fabric of our being and revealing who we are through the events and beliefs that are intricately woven into us. Our task is to awaken, activate and unite all 12, creating a rotation of 12. This rotation of the 12 strands of DNA and 12 chakra will attract to us energies that will intermix and move through our beings, activating and awakening the many different aspects of ourselves. This will trigger new versions, understandings and meanings to all the events in our lives and in our world. Our 12 chakras are energy sets which may arise events. They hold memory and the identity, and each corresponds to one strand of DNA. These 12 energy centers must be accessed from within, where we can feel the corresponding data and translating our experiences within the context of our mind. When open our hearts and minds, all the answers to the great mysteries will be found within us. It takes us to remove us from our current belief systems and to create new belief systems, for the mind is structured to evolve and form our experiences based on what we ordered. Our mind is not our master. We are the masters of our own minds. The mind is only a tool to be used to create reality, and nothing else. Consciously working with the waves of energy and light that enter our land, we are able to realize and understand that the transformation of this planet is based on the healing and power of our mind. An activation of the full 12 DNA strands will create a connection between our human genetic coding and give us access to all knowledge and wisdom. This is the awareness and understanding of who we really are. So we activate all 12 strands of DNA, we create an alignment within ourselves, allowing us to gently shift vibration levels and frequencies of light much higher, helping our ascension process to the awaken our human consciousness. Source: www.spiritpathways.co.za. Kate Sprickly. Copyright 2008. Related posts, thoughts and DNA. DNA accelerated by merger of galaxies. Activation of exponential DNA. Frequency of DNA in the human body. Part DNA 1-2-3. Biology belief. Dr. Bruce Lipton, PhD. Dr. Deepak Chopra. East. The quantum key cure for self-healing and emotional balance. A deliberate how raise your creation vibration energy. Global rise in mass wave X. Going bathing the earth. September wave X. Disperter the SCP wave X. 2015. Dr. Forecasts of Atkins. Human spiritual 1. You do not need to seek a connection with the spirit. He is fully aware of what is spirit, and all the experiences of life, individual and collective, are spiritual expressions. Does not feel separate from any part of creation, feeling intimately connected with the whole. 2. Not afraid of change, individual or collective. You know that every experience is a growth experience and a chance to recreate his own divine presence in human form. He knows the nature of illusion in which he lives and uses it to enhance personal experience and serve humanity. 3. It has no feelings of low esteem. You know that no fragment of all that is has less value and worth than any other. Does not compare with other anyway, privately or publicly, and feels self-conscious of itself, no more than others. not envy or pity from anyone else. For honor all needs and desires above all others. You know that one can truly serve others' will from a codependency or victim and cannot love anyone without first love. 5. Know fully that truth is not maintained by someone or something outside themselves and that the only truth is found within. No need to know, because it has access to everything you ever needed through the higher intuition. 6. You cannot be unfaithful to himself. Does not commit to their own reality and viewpoints in favor of others. Lives embodied life on the basis of I choose and not the I'm afraid. Actions are consistent with words. It does not say one thing and does another. You have no feelings of humiliation. 7. There can be faults with others. He has no desire to misrepresent, to manipulate or control people or events, to be reserved, to be greedy or dishonest even in small details. Lives in the highest integrity at all times. You have the wisdom to know when to speak and when silence, when to act and when not to, but will not change the expression of inner truth in the interest of others. You know that what benefits one must benefit the all in order that the divine order to be maintained. It gives and receives in a balanced flow. 8. Be confident in yourself and consequently trusts others. You know that there are no errors or failures, only choices. It is in tune with the higher consciousness which is orchestrating the divine flow of our human experience and evolution. You have no feelings of guilt, shame, or indecision. It is unaffected by the criticism of others. 9. Has desire to prove right and wrong. You know that all points of view are equally valid and an inherent right of free will. Determines and enforces personal boundaries based on choice rather than fear. He does not argue, nor is dedicated to power struggles. 10. Non-critical and not judge others directly or indirectly. I do not mind listening to criticize and chatter. Do not whine. It does not try to stir up drama and conflict amongst others. Fully knows that the need to criticize and discuss comes from fear. Grants all others the right to be as they are. Do not confuse the actions of the other with being the other. You know that all beings are divine and equal. 11. Opera in the time now. The embodied consciousness is not far in the past or in the future, but only in the now moment and the chosen experience of this moment. Do not worry or have regrets. 12. Is fully able to experience the full extent of human emotion, in addition to being able to choose which emotions or feeling any human experience. No experience uncontrolled and impetuous emotional response of most humans. 13. Makes the choices and decisions of life on higher intuition, rather than the linear and logical thinking, or the survival instincts based on fear of the emotional body. You know that the higher intuition operates in divine flow and is not subject to the inconsistencies of the emotional or mental body. You do not need reasons other than I choose. 14. Do you know the true meaning of love and is incapable of loving any part of creation more or less than any other party? You do not need any particular kind of relationship with other humans, animals, etc. Chooses to intensify relationships with other life experience and releases those who do not do so. You know that you cannot hurt the other, unless the other at some level, has chosen this experience. You know that you cannot be hurt unless you have also chosen this experience. 15. Do not fear any part of creation. Does not experience concern and apprehension. Does not feel threatened by the thoughts, words and actions of any other body, individual or collective, but is alert and aware of the immediate environment and the potential choices presented by it. 16. Do not get attached to people or other forms of life, places or things. Does not suffer from separation or death, because he knows that we are all eternally connected in the One and that the separation that seems to exist on the earth plane is an illusion. 17. Does not experience the normal variations of human life, because it is free of karma and operates at a frequency level above duality. Rarely experiences the illness or injury, because the body is free from the influence of lower emotional thoughts. You can transmute lower energies of others without being affected by them. 18. Do not judge or condemn the events of the world. Know they are a manifestation of the collective consciousness and the most powerful tool to change the world is the very transformation. You can choose to work actively for change in the world if so guided by the higher intuition. 19 is able to act with genuine compassion at all times, serving humanity and providing the aid that is needed in a higher place and no judgment. Has no personal agenda or motivations for assisting others. Choose to do this or not, based on the higher intuition. 20 It has no interest in putting yourself above others, controlling the beliefs or actions of others, taking the personal power of others. It has nothing to prove to others. 21 Honor the limitations imposed by others, individual and collective. Respects the free will and personal space of others at all times and the laws of the land in which he lives. Occasionally chooses exceeds a limit, but does this taking full responsibility for possible consequences. 22 Ups every day with a sense of joy and excitement about what may prove. You have no expectations about what can be experienced, but takes full responsibility as a co-creator. You want to fully experience all that co-created. 23 is an extremely powerful catalyst for change transmutational on Earth. Radiates the higher frequencies of love, light and joy continuously in the planetary consciousness. Cure and transmute the energies of fear for the Earth and its life forms, simply by being in human form.
Hello galactic family. Hello to all who like Gaia Planetary Station, I would like to thank you for being together to learn and grow the light. Improving every step and knowing that the energies of light are making an incredible cleaning in the universe and planet Earth is the great jewelry of this monumental change. All who are connected with their higher self must follow their own missions. Here I present some of the products of the store, search to see if you like something. For those who want to make donations to the channel by PayPal, we have the donation link to the channel. Subscribe to the channel, be a channel member, always comment on the videos and click on like button. Thank you for the amazing messages, the fun conversations and participations in the chat of the videos. I am happy that many warriors of light are together in this new age. May 2021 be incredible for everyone.